Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today we're going to be showcasing a Mandibuzz deck. Mandibuzz is a card that has a lot of potential in the format. This is a Mandibuzz budget deck, and it has the first attack Trash Crash that for 1 dark energy you get to discard an item card from your hand and get to do 60 to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon. Which is a really great attack, and you also have the Brave Bed attack that does 120, which is another solid attack. But we can increase the damage output of the Trash Crash with the new telescopic sights we got in Vivid Voltage that does an extra 30 damage to V and GXs. So you're doing 90 to V's and GXs, which is an alright attack for 1 dark energy off of a stage 1. And we're also playing Ulterior in this list to block GXs and V's, so we're really maximizing out on the spread and block type of archetype. And yeah, to round off this list, we're playing Kangaskhan that has the Rallyback attack that does 120 damage if one of your Pokemon tailed during your last turn. So as a whole, this is just a really nice budget deck that you can build on your own, and the link to this deck list will be in the description. We also play Crushing Hammers in this list just to disrupt our opponent and make sure that our spirit sticks. So yeah, we can also go for the Brave Bed attack because we're playing dark and twin energies in the deck. So yeah, this is a pretty solid budget deck that you can build. As I said before, the link to this deck list will be in the description. And yeah, without further ado, let's get right into some live matches. So guys, it seems as if we're up against a Charizard VMAX deck, and we have the Ulterior in the active. We really need to preserve this Ulterior because we can't take advantage of us blocking the Charizard. And should you mind your opponent? Our opponent didn't really do anything in his last turn. I'm just gonna attach the air balloon to the OB and probably just go for money. Yeah, so guys, we also draw a Caution Hammers and a Jirachi play, so you can switch into the active Caution Hammers and see if you get heads. Yeah, get heads, and hopefully get we can use this. We can go for the Crobat play if it's in the deck. Yeah, we have Crobat in the deck. And we're just gonna play the Chaotic Swirl and Bangu. Yeah. So next turn we can go up into our Ulterior and start walking into this Charizard. So guys, let me know what you think about this type of videos. And my opponent is going for the Welder play, I think. So he's going for research. Opponent is also playing Charizard, the other Charizard in this deck. So we can possibly snipe this Charmander. We can start sniping into the Charmander and start hitting that for damage. Cause that is the only card you don't want. 2022 Switch an die Wii Switch. You can get the Mando bosses, but we do need the Switch, so we can't start poking our opponent. And Bardo's gonna pass again to my opponent. This is what it is. Oh, Charmander has 70 HP. You could probably take in a Galarian Zigzagoon in this deck. Go if you play Scoop Up Net. You could probably take in some Zigzagoons in this deck to ping for 70 in case of matchups like this that our opponent has 70 HP rather than 60. So our opponent is gonna go for Sonya. And let's see what they get. Oh, they have two fire energies. If you can find a boss orders somehow, you can ghost up the Charmander and get a KO on that. Gonna prime into Wisdom. I'm going to Jirachi and go for the Crushing Hammers. And we rip another. We rip the heads. I get the switch. So I'm going to go for another Crushing Hammers and get Tails again. Should we just Brave Bird into this or Trash Crash into the Charmander? I was gonna Trash Crash. Let's see. Probably next turn you can KO the Charmander. Yeah, we really need the Galarian Zigzagoon in this deck to ping for one, cause there are lots of 70 HP mons in the format right now. And you could also reply back with the Kangaskhan if they take a KO on us. So yeah, we're really in a good setup in this matchup. This matchup isn't really too great, cause they didn't really get the Charizard up and rolling. And my opponent was good to the game. So yeah, we're gonna be going to our next game right here. And I'm probably gonna add the telescopic sight into the deck. So stay tuned for our next game. Alright guys, welcome back to the next game, and I've just added in the Galarian Zigzagoon to the deck. Don't worry, I'm gonna update the deck in the description, because in that matchup we really needed the Zigzagoon and I really felt like it was worth it. So let's see what my opponent is playing. It's playing Porygon Z. So I don't really want to discard anything in this hand right now. But I have to discard the twin. Yeah, I'm probably gonna discard the research. I know it's like a hard play to play, but I need the wall beat down. So to Aguno, attach a dark energy, attach telescopic sights and pass our opponent. Let's see what my opponent is playing on his side. Hopefully we can draw a support card off of this, off of our top deck. So he's playing Whimsicott. We can snap the Whimsicott. Yeah, we can snap the Whimsicott down and take a prize. Oh no, we don't have an item card in hand. So I guess we're just gonna draw for one. Because we whiffed the item card and we just draw it on the top deck. And they get the red candy play. So they probably have a research in hand. Just by my guess. No, they're just gonna go for the Polygon Z knockout on us. And we could reply back with the Kangaskhan if they knock us out. Play the capture energy down, and yeah, we could start sniping the Zacian for 90. They go for the Dedenne. They're already down by one energy, and we're already blocking their Whimsicott with our Altaria. So I'm not really sure what my opponent can go for, and he's limited to the amount of triple acceleration energy he can play. He only has, I believe, two more in deck. So hopefully we can get, we can use the Crobat and draw to our six. And we get the Altaria, but no, we don't get the Twin Energy. So let's see if we can get up this Guru. Get the boss. Oh. We're gonna go for money. I don't still get it, so I'm gonna question hammer the MR energy off of him, and yeah, we're gonna pass. Now let's see how my opponent responds. He's going for it, probably going to see knockouts probably. What does he have a triple in hand? He has the twin and the recycled energy. Another recycled energy. So by him going for a knockout here, we can probably respond with the Kangaskhan, and he wouldn't have any acceleration again. So if we can get that off, we just need to get a supporter here, and we just need to hope that Jirachi, now we just need to hope that Jirachi can get us what we need. Switch, no, I just want to pick up the money, priming to his dome. Play down the 6 again, ping this and go for the money play. Hopefully we can get a switch or a scoop of nets for this hand. Yeah, we draw it. So yeah, adding the Galarian Zigzagoon is a great tech into this deck. I'm gonna play it on ordinary mode and get the Ulterior backup. Yeah, I'll get to you. Although we're down by attackers though, but we still block his deck, we still have the interior for game. And he plays down another Porygon. If he had the Mandibles up, he could probably have sniped it down, but we don't have that play of the Beatles. Probably just gonna go for the Jirachi. We are going to pick up the switch. Oh, just gonna Erika's hospitality. Oh, I don't still sure what you need. We are really down bad. I'm just gonna pick up the scoop of next. Oh wow, well, they're gonna pass cloud to me. Next turn, your opponent has a play, he can KO us and we can KO back his Porygon. You need to clean out the deck. You finally get the communications, you get that basic on the field. We're going to go for another Sobble and scoop up next the Zigzagoon and play that down and attach the dark energy. So I'm gonna pass and see if our opponent can have an answer to this. So if they knock us out here, we're just gonna knock them back. We're just gonna knock them back out. They are probably gonna see back out. And there goes another triple acceleration. So my opponent can't really attack us anymore. Yep. Down to triple acceleration. No, they are down by all their triple acceleration. And by them going into the winter court, we can knock back. We can knock out their Porygon Z once more. So probably go for the KO. We still have a win condition, that being we still have Altaria in the deck. So if we can get that up, we probably won the game. Although it's gonna be a close call. And we don't still seem to find what we need. I'm gonna switch into the second Jirachi. Yeah, I was gonna go with the money. Yes. And we finally get the play of the people. Let's see if my opponent has anything to respond. He goes to a research, so he doesn't have a boss in hand, which is great to see. Probably has a boss in hand, so he's probably won this game. Of course, I believe he hasn't played any boss. What's his orders? Charge this game. Yeah, like I said. So I was gonna scoop this game. Yeah, guys, this video is already long enough already. If you like this video, remember to leave a like and subscribe for more content, and yeah, I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out.